Hi students, this is T. Balakrishna, Chemistry Lecture, GPT Kottagudem. Today our topic is Tyndall effect. Tyndall effect. So this Tyndall effect only occur in colloidal solution only. So here Tyndall effect means the colloidal particles are larger in the size and scattering the light passing through the colloidal. This is called Tyndall effect. When you are pass the light to the colloidal solution, that light is scattered by the colloidal particle. That is called Tyndall effect. You want to clear a clarification about the Tyndall effect. First, we prepare two mixtures. One is a homogeneous mixture. That is a solution. So this is a homogeneous mixture. This is solution. Okay, it is a heterogeneous mixture, colloidal solution. In this solution, it is in a homogeneous mixture because the solute particle size is less than 10 angstroms. It is in a colloidal solution. The particle size is in between the 10 angstroms to 2000 angstroms. It is in a colloidal solution. It is in a heterogeneous mixture. One is dispersed phase, another one is a dispersed medium. It is in a solution. It contains two components. One is a salt and water. Salt is a solute, water is a solvent. It is in a homogeneous mixture, it is in a solution. It is in a heterogeneous mixture, colloidal solution. I try to explain the Tyndall effect in colloidal solution. Before going to discuss about the Tyndall effect in colloidal solution, first we pass the light to the normal solution. Here the light ray is directly passed through the water solution. The light passed through the solution. There is no scattering of light. The light pass from one end to another end clearly. Here light transfer from one end to another end without scattering of light. So you observe the end, one end to another end. This is one end, this is another end. Okay, so next we observe the Tyndall effect in colloidal solution. When you pass the light through the colloidal solution, you observe the path of light. It is in a cone shape. So we observe the path of light. We didn't see the second end of the light. But in this solution, we see the second end of the solution. Okay, second end of the light. So it is in a first end, it is in a second end of the light. So we see this end of the light. But in colloidal solution, we didn't see the end of the light. Second end of the light, that is called colloidal effect, and we see the path of the light. This is the path of the light. This may occur due to the scattering of the the colloidal particles scattering the light. Is it clear? We observe the path. This is in a path of light. This phenomena only occur in only colloidal solution. We didn't see that pathway. Light pathway in normal solution. Just we see the second end of the light. Is it clear? Okay, right? This is in a colloidal solution, scattering of the light. We see the path of the light in a colloidal solution. The scattering of the light is called Tyndall effect, that occurred in only colloidal solutions only. We didn't see that phenomena in normal solution. Okay, what is the definition of Tyndall effect? Scattering of the light passing through the colloidal solution. Scattering the light passing through the colloidal solution. Light scattering out in the epidu colloidal solution on the light to pass station. We see the path of the light. So that may occur to the scattering effect of colloidal particles. We didn't see the type of phenomena in normal solution. Is it clear? One end. And this is in a first end of the light, and this is the second end of the light. we have observed in only normal solution. We didn't observe that second and in colloidal solution. Okay, we observe only path of the light, because the colloidal particle size is greater than normal solution particles, so they're scattering the light. Okay, right? I repeat the definition. The colloidal particles are larger in size and scatter the light passing through the colloid. This is called Tyndall effect. Thank you, student. This is T. Balakrishna, Chemistry Teacher.